sense. And Kelly Diedring is joining us this morning to tell us all about it. Because Kelly, I think this is the coolest thing. Not only do you have a great product, but you have an incredible price where you're saving over $16. Yes. But actually, you're saving more from buying those rock hard dog treats that the dogs don't need.
Well, not only are you saving money, but you're feeding your dog healthier too, because these are gonna be whatever you wanna put in them. They're gonna be all natural. If you wanna do vegetarian, if you wanna do bacon or peanut butter, it comes with 35 recipes. So you don't even have to figure it out. We tell you how to do it. But let me tell you everything you get. This is that as seen on TV. You've probably seen the infomercial. It's so popular right now, and there's a good reason. You're getting this adorable machine, which I love, it's in the shape of the bone. And then we're also including, which usually this is an extra, we're also including two of the mixes. So you're getting the bacon and you're getting the peanut butter mix, and all you do is add water. Right down here, it makes 24 bones each mix. So that's a lot of really, really healthy treats.
Yeah, it is.
And you get the recipe booklet, like I mentioned, 35 recipes. But let's just make some.
Okay.
Right inside here, I've already made our bacon treats. Okay. Look what we've got here. So all we did was we added a little egg, some wheat flour, mm-hmm. all ingredients that are really, really good and healthy for your dog, and then little bits of bacon mm-hmm. that I cooked up myself. I'm gonna pop those over here. Now I've got the mix. Okay. This is my batter. All I did was add water. But it could also be one of those recipes that you've made yourself, or one of the recipes from the booklet. And then look how easy it is. It has these perfectly shaped little bones on the inside, mm-hmm. and this is all completely non-stick, so you don't have to worry about spraying any extra chemicals or oils or even butter. Okay. So that's what's so great about this, is that you can actually put into your dog treats now exactly what you want in your dog treats. Mm-hmm. You know, Tamara, there are over 70 million dogs in the United States.
Is that right?
70 million dogs. And I mean, doesn't pretty much everybody you know has a dog, and yeah. we love our dogs.
Yeah.
And 50% of our dogs are overweight. Think about that, 50%. Now all I'm gonna do, pop that down and lock it.
Okay.
And then they're gonna bake in about 8 minutes. Okay. Sometimes they'll be 5 to 10, just depends on the recipe, but it's all in the booklet.
Okay.
But the reason that we do have this epidemic of pets that are overweight is because we're not feeding them foods that are healthy for them. You know, there's this wave now mm-hmm. that we're really conscientious about what we're putting in our own bodies. We're really looking at labels. We're trying not to eat chemicals and preservatives and fillers and, you know, stuff that we might be allergic to. Why not do that for your pets?
I know.
Because
yeah.
the thing about it is, they're sometimes, you mentioned, they're the favorites of our family. I mean, I know my dogs are my favorite in my family. I've got two of them, and we're gonna meet one in just a minute.
Okay.
Rocky's here, and I'm like a proud mom.
Okay.
But he used to be overweight by like about 10 pounds. You know, we think that we're loving our pets by giving them extra treats and extra food,
yeah.
but dogs that are overweight don't live as long. Mm-hmm. Now, you see, we've got our oat treats
yeah.
that we made. These are Nora's oat biscuits.
Okay.
I'm gonna pop those out here,
okay.
and then I'm gonna bring in Rocky.
Okay.
Because I want to show you how much the dogs love these treats. The treats are soft and gooey and healthy yeah. and delicious.
Which is different from when you buy treats from a bag, because they're so hard because of all of the extras and preservatives that are in them.
You're right, and they're soft. So watch, he absolutely loves them. And the treats are the perfect size for any dog. You can break them up if you've got smaller guys, but it also, like you said, you have Yorkies.
Yeah, I do.
They're the perfect size, and he's literally drooling all over the place. Can you give me a kiss? I love my little puppy.
No, Rocky, wag your tail if you like the treats.
He's obsessed with these treats. I mean, honestly, he gets so excited when you say the word cookie, because he knows what he's getting. Sit.
Oh, he's good.
Okay, that's the only trick my dog knows. He doesn't spin or shake or do anything, but he sits and eats cookies really, really well.
And
so I'm proud of that.
And you don't have a problem feeding these to him.
Right,
because you know what's in them,
that's
because they're healthy.
That's absolutely right.
And that's the thing. Do you know what's in your dog's treats? When you go to the big pet stores and they have those aisles and aisles and aisles full of those treats, you pick up the bag. Most of the time, we don't turn it around to see what's in it.
Right.
We just assume, well, it's for the dog, it's gonna be good. But you know they're rock hard.
Yes.
Would you eat anything that rock hard?
No.
So why are we serving it to our pets? You know what? This is all something that you can make at home. You know what's in it. And as a reminder, you're getting two of the mixes right off the bat, and all you have to do is add water. After that, you can always come back to hsn.com and get more mixes, Or follow the one of 35 recipes in the booklet that you get.
There they are.
And then you can make your own. So because some dogs, just like us, like you said, they're finicky. They only like to eat certain things.
Yes.
Maybe it's your budget can, you know, can determine what you want them to eat, whatever it is.
You mentioned other dog treats. I picked up this package of just generic dog treats that you might be feeding your dog. The very first ingredient is flour, corn, sorbitol, glucose syrup, water. It's like the 12th ingredient before we get to some kind of a meat product or something that's good for them. So when you start reading labels for yourself, now is the time to read labels for your pet.
Kelly, there are like, no kidding, 45 ingredients in there.
And you cannot even pronounce them. And I always say this, I do a lot of healthy cooking shows on HSN.
Yeah.
I say if you can't pronounce it, your body can't digest it. It's the same for our pets. Mm-hmm. Our pets, we want them to be healthy. Pets that are healthy and not overweight live years longer.
Yes.
So just by overfeeding your pets, you're actually doing them a disservice. They may not be with you for as long,
and
they're not going to be as healthy.
And the thing is, we just want to do the right thing. And if we think we're doing the right thing, but once you find out that there is a different way, there is a better way, that's when it's time to step up and try that better way. And that's what this is. If you can pour a mix into the little well and close the lid, you can do this. And it's so worth it, too. I don't think it's a luxury. I think when you see how much your dogs love this and take to this versus the others, you're gonna say, thank goodness I made the decision to get this.
Yes.
It's called Bake a Bone, and that's what you're doing. Look at him.
I know, aren't these cute? I just wanna read some of the recipes, because these are like gourmet recipes for your pet, and they're all 100% healthy. Apple cinnamon bones, bacon bites, banana bones, birthday bones. I love this one. Thanksgiving treats with your Thanksgiving leftovers.
Oh, good.
Now you can put it, how about your steak dinner, your leftovers from steak dinner? Cheesy bones, all of these different bones, and you can do them yourself. And look how delicious.
Yeah.
You could do like a gluten-free bone if you know that your pet has allergies to gluten or wheat. You could do your cheesy bone right here. I love these. This is mint and parsley. These are fresh breath bones.
Oh.
So if you have a dog that has kind of a breath issue, like my little Rocky kind of does, you could do like a peanut butter bone, a bacon bone, oats. So that's what I love, is that it comes with all these recipes. It also comes with recipes for the icing. Mm-hmm. So if you're one of those folks that does the birthday parties for the dog and you hand out the doggy bags,
oh, how cute,
which we have down here for the pets, now is the time to do it. Here's another really great idea. If your kids or grandkids need to raise money, or you want them to start earning their own money, they can bake the dog treats and sell them.
How
wouldn't purchase in your neighborhood? Think of them going door to door or at maybe like a church fundraiser or a soccer fundraiser, selling these to raise money during the summer.
This is such a good idea.
Because they're so healthy. The other idea somebody came up with this morning, you know, Father's Day is coming up. Mm-hmm. Buy the Bake-A-Bone for the father of your pet. So, and then give it to the dad as if it's from the dog. As a Father's Day gift from the dog. I absolutely love that idea.
I
was like,
that.
How cute, and sign it with a little paw print.
Oh, I love that.
Yeah, because I mean, it's such a great gift, you know, for those fathers of dogs. We're daddies, we're mommies of our pets, you know? And I want to open this and just show you what's going on inside here.
Okay.
Because look at that. They're nearly finished.
And you know what, and they're soft too.
Yeah, and that's the great thing you mentioned. They're soft. Look at this, it is a perfect treat. It's gonna be a little bit hot, but I'm gonna grab it because I want to show that it's soft on the inside instead of crunchy.
Yeah.
You know those treats that are hard and crunchy? That's because they're filled with chemicals and preservatives. That's because they have to be shelf stable, not with Bake-A-Bone. Now you just pop these in your refrigerator or even your freezer, Tamara.
Yeah.
If you want to keep them in your freezer, you absolutely can.
This is such a good idea.
I love
all of the different ideas that we're showing you with the different flavors, but you add what your dogs love because what's so great is that if you have multiple dogs, you can make treats just for them. It doesn't take a lot of time. Just like Kelly said, it's between 5 and 10 minutes, depending on what you put in it. You can even write their name on it or write a little message, which they can't read, but maybe they can. Some dogs can read.
I bet Rocky can.
You know what? Let's go on over to see Rocky, because again,
Rocky loves it. The treats. And here's the deal. This is the original. Bake-A-Bone are the inventors of this. So you know they've got the market. They know what they're doing. Can you sit for me? Thank you. It's also patented. So if you're looking at that infomercial, you're actually saving, I think you said it was like over $16 from the infomercial price if you get it today on HSN.
Mm-hmm.
But the dogs absolutely love the treats. I don't know if you can even see, but there's like drool coming off of his mouth.
He loves it.
Rocky.
You know what? What's so funny too is when we talk about the savings, it's about $16 if you were gonna buy this off of infomercial with everything that, you know, that goes along with that. But you get it today for less than $30. But think about how much you save. Those regular dog treats are expensive.
They are expensive.
And how often do you buy those? So this is brand new. It's 264-253. That's the item number to get this home. You're gonna get the two boxes, peanut butter and bacon, as well as the recipe book with 35 recipes, as well as, of course, the treat maker.
Yep.
Kelly, thank you so much.
And I know who's cleaning this up.
I know.
Rocky.
Kelly's gonna be back at 6 o'clock with another look, but you can go ahead and get yours now.